Hello everyone, this is Jim Escott. I'm here to show you how to do your Form 185 using member management today. So the first step is go to the internet, click on www.kofc.org. Once you're here at the state website, you come over here to sign in. To sign in, you put in your username and your password. Now, before I click sign in, if you forgot your username, you can click on Account Assistant and it will help you get your username back. If you forgot your password, you click on Password Reset and it will guide you through getting your password reset. So since I already know my username and password, I'm just going to click on sign in. Once you're signed in to Officers Online, you then scroll down here. You'll see this member management button. You click on this. I would like you to go to the live version, but since this is just a training demonstration, I'm going to go to the training section here. Both of them look identical, but please, when you go in here, click on live. I'm going to click on training since this is just an example. So here's what member management looks like when you get in. You click on council administration. And here's where it says council officers, current and next. There's two different versions here. There's the current year and next year. So let's talk about current year first. So for current year, if you look at this, it shows you down here, here's your positions, here's all the people who are currently named, their membership numbers and their start dates. And let's say I want to change who the elector is. So I would come up here. Say I want to pick a different elector. I then want to key in someone's last name. And let's choose Martin as the last name. Click on search. And if I look at this, it shows me that there's one member of the council with the last name of Martin. His name is Greg. So I would click on that and then hit assign. With leaving the start date blank, it just uses today's date for the start date. If you want a different date as to when they actually started, you can change that and put that in there. But now if I just hit assign, come down here and look, you will see that the elector is now Greg Martin. There's his membership number and there's his start date. So that's how that works. You would then hit submit, which sends it to Supreme, and now you're done. And it says here, go to the print center to generate the report. So now that you've actually submitted to Supreme, Supreme has a copy of it, but no one else has a copy of it. You could always come back in here and relook at it. But you should also send a copy to your district deputy and other people. So you click on the print center, you click on current officers, it's going to generate a report. And then you click here to open up the report. You can save a copy, it's a PDF, and then email it to the Michigan State Council at forms.mikfc.org. You should also send a copy to your district deputy and send a copy to anyone else in your council if you need to do so. So let me get out of here. The next thing I want to show you, we talked about this, is for current and next year. Notice I just looked at the current year form. So now if I go to next year, it gives me this option to say copy the current year people into the next year. So once you get into the May-June timeframe and you have to rename all your officers, typically half of the people, if not more, remain in their same positions from year after year. So if you just copy the current year, it's going to automatically populate all these people from the current year to the next year. And this all starts July 1st of the next year, which is 2020. And then you can start making changes to this. So these you only have to update individual ones for people who change from year to year, and then go through the same process. Hit submit. Go to the print center to print a copy, and you're done. That's all I have to show you. Thanks, everybody, for watching.